The Neon Puppet Show by Tanuj and Tanish. According to the ancient Chinese legend, there was a ferocious monster named Neon with sharp teeth and horns. Secluding itself in the dark sea for a long time, the beast would go onshore by the end of every lunar year and hunt people and livestock. So, before the end of New Year's Eve, all the villagers would escape to remote mountains to avoid the Neon's attack. There is a twist for this year's New Year's Eve. When all the people were finding a spot to take refuge in the mountains, a strange old man walked into the village. With silver hair and bright eyes, he walked towards them. Everyone ran to their shelters in the mountain, thinking that he was a bad omen and a form of death, except for one old lady. "What are you waiting for? Come on, come to hide in the refuge." "No, ma'am, I am a monk, and I have an offer for you." "What is it?" "If you let me stay in your house for one day, I shall help your village fight the Neon." "Okay, but what if you fail in scaring the Neon away? What's more, what if it eats you?" "Then I shall not hear to be disturbing you by tomorrow morning." Back at the village. How does he think he can chase off the Neon, an immensely large beast reputedly endowed with a jaw vast enough to seize and devour a multitude of people in a single swallow? It is a terror to behold indeed, with its massive horns, enormous tail, and an unnatural appearance that combined the powerful frame of a bull with the snarling head of a lion. "I don't know how, but I trust this man." At night, the monster broke into the village finally, but it sensed the change in the atmosphere. In the past, the entire village was in dead darkness, but this time around, the houses in the east were brightly lit. The Neon approached the well-lit houses slowly. It found all the doors and windows plastered with red papers. The beast trembled, glaring. Caught by rage, it swooped to the front door. At that very moment, a loud sound burst in the courtyard, warning the Neon not to dare come closer. The front door was open, and the old man came out in a red gown, laughing. The Neon was scared, running away through the dark night. The next day, villagers returned back to the tribe, surprised at the undamaged scene of the woman. At that moment, it dawned on the old granny that the relief from the Neon had come from the old man's promise. She hastened to other villagers and told them about the old man's commitment. To check the truth, all the people flocked to the old granny's house, and they found the red papers on doors and windows, candles in the house, and the burnt bamboo in the courtyard. They understood why the Neon ran off. "Yay! He is like an angel. We are indebted." This is how the Neon tale ended. The village made him the chief. Never did they disobey him. And so, they lived happily ever after. The end.
有时候开的春天绽放幸福的笑颜，
让我们对着天空许心愿，
不愉快说再见，
相信今日会有奇迹降临，
你会找到你的幸运星，
相信我会为你加油打气，
天塌下来我为你滴。
最重要，我们在一起就好。 见，相信今年会有奇迹降临，你会找到你的幸运星，相信我会为你加油打气，天塌下来我为你顶，要记得笑一笑把烦恼忘掉，要记得抱一抱世界更美妙，财神也来报道，好运把你围绕，只要我们在一起就好，要记得笑一笑把怪兽打倒，要记得抱一抱今年会更好，幸福过每一秒，开心过最重要，我们在一起就好，
Chinese celebrate Chinese New Year on a different day. This depends on the moon, the date of Chinese New Year. But it always falls sometime between 21 January and 20 February. Next year, the Chinese New Year will be slightly earlier than this year.